We're here in Kansas City to rally for Brent Welder. We're going to flip this seat red in November.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Talking about a little AOC news. It's news. It just broke in the last 5 minutes. But not really. AOC owes $2,000 in unpaid taxes from failed business venture. Now, this was actually May 17th, so this was a day ago. Wait, oh, hold up. Breaking news, hold up. Oh, what's this? New York Post again, March 23rd, 2019. Not really breaking news, right? We'll just talk about this in brief. This debt is from 6 or 7 years ago from a failed business, I guess. I don't know if any of you are familiar with this, aware of it. I don't know how many of you care. Does it matter? No, not really. U.S. Rep. Alexandria Ocasio Cortez wants to raise taxes on the rich, but not pay her own, says the New York Post. The Democratic Socialist Congresswoman from the Bronx still hasn't paid a 7-year-old tax bill left over from a failed business venture. AOC had founded Brook Avenue Press, a publishing house that sought designers, artists, and writers from urban areas to help paint the Bronx in a positive way in children's stories in 2012. Doesn't that just sound like something she would do? That she would be involved in the making of children's stories? Probably something, I don't know, probably something that's taking up a lot of space on her bookshelf. As the Post previously reported, public records show the state dissolved the company in October 2016. The state can make such a move when the business fails to pay corporate taxes or file a tax return. The state tax department then filed a warrant against her now-defunct business on July 6, 2017, over a $1,618.36 unpaid bill. Yada, yada, yada. The outstanding balance has grown to $2,088.78, the department said. We'll skip ahead a little bit. You get the gist of it. I'll spare you the details. It says here, but Ocasio Cortez Camp says the rep is challenging the bill because it was issued in error. Oh, look at her. I love her when she adjusts those glasses like that. Ooh. The congresswoman is still in the process of contesting the tax warrant. The business has been closed for several years now, and so we believe that the state tax department has continued to collect the franchise tax in error, says Lauren Hitt, an AOC spokeswoman. As anyone who's tried to contest a tax bill in error knows, it takes time, Hitt added. That's true. AOC, a first-term incumbent, will face Democratic voters in the June 23rd primary in the 14th Congressional District, covering portions of the Bronx and Queens. They go on to talk about her some more, whatever, you can read that there. Now, first of all, you know I love me some AOC news, baby. Actually, this is meaningless to me, but even though she's fighting it, what I don't get is perhaps why not just pay it and then appeal it? I don't know if that's a thing, if she could do that, just to avoid the bad press, because they keep coming out with these stories all the time. And like I said, I don't like her. I think she's a despicable person. There's very few politicians that I put that label on. Somebody who cost the district 25,000 jobs, who was directly involved in that, then got on and gloated about it, and then tried to walk it back like she wasn't involved in that, that's somebody who's despicable to me. Somebody who costs Americans that many jobs, people in her district. I don't know how people could vote to reelect her. I get it, the celebrity thing. People want to be associated with fame and wealth and say, oh, I voted for her, that's my girl right there. But I just don't understand how people could support somebody that had such a direct involvement in costing the district that many jobs and then went on to brag about it. You can talk about all the other things, but that's the one thing for me that makes me think she's despicable. Now, again, I don't care about the tax bill. I think she should have just paid it and been done with it. It's not like she doesn't have the money now rolling in from whatever funds she's got going on in her salary, which is, what do they say, 140, 150 grand? I don't know the exact number, but just pay the stupid thing. Avoid the bad press. And then maybe you can go back and dispute it later if you wanted to, or if you want to try to. But again, avoid that bad press. Now, let me conclude this by saying a couple things. Primary's up on June 23rd. I hope Michelle Caruso Cabrera wins the Democratic primary in the district. Heavily Democratic district there, so whoever wins the primary is going to go on and win the general in November. Most likely. I mean, they went for Ocasio by, what, 50, 60 points before, I forget the number. Whoever wins that primary is winning that district. So I hope Michelle wins it. I think she'd be great for the district, more of a moderate type individual. I'm not going to act like I know everything about her. Like I said, I don't want somebody costing Americans 25,000 jobs and then being out there bragging about it. That's a piece of shit to me. Second, I had a dispute with the IRS before, and this was actually not so much of a dispute to begin with. It was them bending me over and taking all my money out of my account. And I was actually overseas at the time that this happened, so it was hard to kind of coordinate the time and call them and everything like that. What happened was, it was, I think it was regarding like 2009 or 10 taxes, something like that. At that time, if you have mutual funds, if you know how those work in terms of the tax side of it, when you generate a sale, purchase something else, generate another sale, you used to have to fill those out manually, either on the forms or on tax software programs. And it was actually my mistake that led them to audit me. And what happened was, I didn't fill out all of the transactions. There were so many because I was trying to time the market or whatever, which didn't work out for me at that time. They went ahead, audited it, and then saw these records and that I didn't report some of the sales, like the losses or gains on it. So what happened was, they took all the money out of my bank account. The bank charged me a $100 fee for the convenience of allowing the IRS to take my money. So I had to go through the process, dispute it and everything like that. So when they went ahead later and looked at all the transactions and went ahead and added everything up, it turned out they ended up owing me money. Isn't that funny? And like I said, they were just minor transactions. Like, it'd be like $5 made here, $10 made there, $5 lost here and there. And like I said, there were so many of them, I just didn't want to do it. And I knew I wasn't cheating in any way, but just, it was like 40 something transactions. And I was like, I don't want to handwrite all these out, or I don't want to enter these in the computer. I can't remember at the time what it was. I think most likely I was handwriting them. I just didn't want to do it. It just wasn't worth the time for me to try to get that extra money. And when the IRS went and processed it, it turned out they ended up owing me like $150 or something like that. So I do know that it takes time. Now, obviously, her situation's different. They end up owing me money. The tax department there claims she owes money, but it does take time. I get that. And again, I came out in the end winning. Of course, my bank wouldn't refund me that $100 they took, like I said, for the convenience of allowing the IRS to drain my bank account. Like I said, it takes time, but we've got the primary coming up on June 23rd. Hopefully she loses. If she doesn't, it's not going to be the end of the world for me, but I'd love to see her lose. I would love to see her go down. And again, she probably should have just paid the thing and disputed it later, because it's just the optics. You know, the other side is going to run with it and run these stories all the time. We've seen two here, and I'm sure there are probably hundreds of other stories that get run every year, every 2 years. It's red meat, baby. All right, everybody. Quick story. Thanks for watching. Take care, everybody. Hope you're all doing well.